Zambia is currently facing a jobs challenge. Despite high levels of economic growth, averaging 7.9% between 2007 and 2013, Zambia continues to face a jobs challenge. This is because the formal sector jobs only increased by 3.4% over the same period. Today, nearly 500,000 Zambian people are unemployed. To help respond to the scale of the challenge, the Zambia Institute for Policy Analysis and Research, ZIPER, has embarked on a flagship project called More and Better Jobs.
The objectives of the More and Better Jobs flagship project is to try and establish what the employment challenges are in Zambia, and to also try and understand these ambitions that the economy has to create more and better jobs. What we have done is we have set up a secretariat at ZIPER, comprising of four people who coordinate the day-to-day operations of the research project. Beyond those four people, we have a full-fledged team, or four teams, of about four people each, internally in ZIPER, who are also responsible for doing the actual technical work.
Although it is largely understood that the private sector is the primary engine for job creation, recently a debate has emerged on the appropriate role of the state on employment policy. As such, an important goal of the flagship project will be to help shape the thinking around the role the state should play in job creation. But what does the Zambian society think on the role of the state in jobs creation? Here is what selected members of the public and key stakeholders had to say on the question, is it government's role to create jobs?
Yes, in a way that like in my mind, the government, they have to attract investors. You know, they give them, say, like taxation and everything. So my investors, but it's one way government is creating nchito. It's not necessarily nchito kupesa government. No, government can never accommodate every youth in government.
The government cannot necessarily create employment for everyone. That's a must. And when they tend to create employment, the only thing that the government is supposed to do is to enforce policy to the people in the private sectors that are employing the youths.
But it's their role. They are just supposed to, because we depend on them anyway.
No. You know, that is a mistake which most of people are making. If we wait for government to create these jobs, we'll be making a mistake. There are policies, there are programs, there are projects which we can lobby government support and create employment.
Yes, at a government level, government issues policy directions. And these are policy directions which will help to make sure that the jobs are created in a honorable situation. In the first place, we need to initiate the policy direction. And even when the private sector are engaged in certain jobs, they will be following the policy directions which are already lined up by government.
Obviously, it's not a black and white answer. The reason government is creating jobs is not for purposes of creating jobs. And this has to be very clear. By the way, even the private sector is not creating jobs for purposes of creating jobs. The private sector is looking for an opportunity to make money. The government is trying to put in place a conducive environment for the private sector to thrive. Now, what constitutes this conducive environment? It's the laws, the regulations, it's the infrastructure. So to provide the laws, the policies, and the regulations, government has to employ people to do that. That's how government creates those jobs. But the jobs created by government are a means to creating a conducive environment. The jobs created by the private sector are a means to making money.
It's not necessarily the government's role to create jobs for every citizen of the Republic of Zambia, no. But it's up to you and me to stand up and be your own employer. The skill that you have attained, the skill that I've attained, it's important that you and me must stand up and create jobs and employ others. It's very important. Who is the government? When you say the government is you and me.
It is not something where we can say whether it is the government's job or not. Yes, government has a big role to play. What's the role of the government? Government's role is to provide a conducive environment for businesses to thrive, both domestic and foreign investors to come in. And what do we mean by conducive business environment? You need to have good macroeconomic stability. Zambia has always enjoyed this political stability. Along with that, we need to have a very stable macroeconomic environment. You need to have good policies, and that's something that provides the incentive for private sector to come and invest. And more than anything else, what we call as public goods means roads, the bridges, the energy, water resources, all those things that are necessary for businesses to create economic activities. So in that sense, to create a conducive business environment, the government has a big role to play. On the other hand, is government should be in the job of creating jobs? We don't think so. We need to allow private sector to be able to flourish, so can become a big source of employment generation to a vast majority of Zambians.
Responding to the dual challenge of unemployment and poor quality jobs is perhaps Zambia's biggest priority. Tackling Zambia's jobs challenge will require concerted action from across the Zambian society. In view of this, ZIPA's groundbreaking project will draw on expertise from across the Zambian society.
We have put together an advisory group, a group of people from different institutions. These are key experts. We have five government departments or ministries. We have Cabinet Office, we have Ministry of Finance, Ministry of Labour and Social Securities, Ministry of Youth and Sport, among others. We also have private sector representation. And the idea behind this advisory group is that they would be our strategic advisors, so telling us what directions to take in undertaking the research, what are the relevant policy issues, what are the relevant strategic issues that we need to focus on and be in a better position down the road to inform the public. The idea is these same people, the advisory group, will help us to also connect those messages into the right hands. The project is expected to be in project phase from this June until December 2016. And the idea is to generate new evidence on where more and better jobs would come from in Zambia now and in the future, making sure that throughout we are planning for an expanding population, an expanding labor force, an increasing amount of urbanization. So with those plans, we are expecting that during the duration of the project, we'll be able to tell the different policymakers, we'll be able to tell private sector practitioners about how to do things differently in order to improve the job landscape. Of course, we also have a function to play in sensitizing the public about what should be understood as more and better jobs.
ZIPA's flagship project on more and better jobs will address what is perhaps the greatest challenge Zambia will face in the coming decades. Throughout the project, ZIPA will ask and address some fundamental policy questions in order to provide stronger, more systematic and more comprehensive and conclusive answers to the jobs challenge in Zambia.